Hello and welcome to this edition of the weekly market update in coordination with Orbex.com. So the key event is finally behind us and the USD index is finally trading according to our previous plan mentioned in our previous reports and our previous videos. The Federal Reserve decided to raise the Fed fund rate by 25 basis points as widely expected, but they also left the economic projection almost unchanged, yet the USD declined sharply across the board. Many traders were sending requests and questions asking about the reasons behind the US dollar decline, despite the fact that the Federal Reserve has raised rates. And this is exactly what we warned about in our previous videos, previous reports, and more importantly, the article that we sent out right before the Federal Reserve decision on that day. And actually, Janet Yellen did a very great job in this meeting, as she managed to raise the Fed fund rate by 25 basis points, but she also kept the US dollar under pressure, side by side with the US 10-year bond yields. In addition to that, the US stock market kept on rising and we have seen some sort of a stabilizing. One of the reasons also behind the US dollar decline is that one of the members voted against raising rates and he voted in favor to hold the rates unchanged. Moreover, the Federal Reserve has shown was less hawkish, unlike the market estimates or unlike the market expectations, which turned the table upside down. What's important here is that the US dollar index needed back then only a catalyst to complete the head and shoulders pattern, which basically the one that we were talking about over the past 2 weeks. And the Fed's decision was the catalyst for this pattern. And this is when fundamentals and technical analysis are merged. And definitely we will talk about it about the US dollar index outlook later in this video. But for the time being, let's head to the UK. The Brexit is happening and the Article 50 will be triggered anytime or in the coming days, probably before the end of this week. But at the same time, what's interesting is that last week, one of the MPC members or the Bank of England members voted to hike the rates by 25 basis points, given the fact that inflation showed a notable pickup in the recent months. And this is one of the reasons also behind the big spike that we saw in cable or in British pound pairs last week. But if you're asking, will this change or will this change the bearish outlook on the cable or British pound? Not so soon, because again, the British pound is likely to remain weak over the coming weeks. But as for the EU, some of the talks right now is rising about the ECB raising the interest rates before the end of this year, or at least before the end of the QE. On Thursday, one of the ECB members noted that they might need to raise the discount rate or the deposit rate before the end of the QE program, which means before the end of this year, which means that the market is likely to start pricing in a rate hike by the ECB very soon. And in addition to that, don't forget that tapering is happening very soon. And in return, the euro is likely to stay away from its recent lows and might not even test the parity with the US dollar, the one that most of the banks were talking about a long time ago, anytime soon, with the possibility of a notable rebound later this year. As for the week ahead, it's likely to be very calm with a few key events such as the monetary policy meeting minutes in Australia. We have also the Reserve Bank of New Zealand decision. In the UK, we will be watching the inflation figures as well. But most importantly, eyes will be again on the Federal Reserve Chair Yellen's speech on Thursday, which might be another catalyst for the US dollar sell-off. So those are the most important subjects that I wanted to highlight at the beginning of the video. But now let's have a closer look at our technical charts. Beginning with the US dollar index as always, and as we noticed and as we said last week that we were watching the right shoulder of the full pattern of the head and shoulder pattern to develop, and finally we've seen a very good move, as we said at the beginning of the video, because of the Federal Reserve rate hike and the less hawkishness from the statement. So that's why we've seen a very good decline, and also we broke through many key levels, including the 50, the 100-day moving average, the one that we also got some support back in January around like 99.35. But right now we have a clear break to the downside on the daily chart, and even on the weekly chart we have a very good confirmation for further declines ahead. However, we still have some more levels to break before completing the pattern. However, so far, and as I said, we might see some sort of another decline all the way. First of all, we will have to watch the 100 barrier, and the 99.35 support is the next support. However, we would like also, I would love to see some sort of a retracement to the upside before that, because technical indicators are almost like heavily over
oversold on most of the time frames, despite the fact that also the RSI is still below the 50, but also it's flat. So we might see some sort of an upside retracement before the declines continue. However, in both cases, we're still bearish on the US dollar index, especially also after the Federal Reserve decision and after the Federal Reserve statement, most likely toward 99.35, and could be even below that. We might even test the 200-day moving average or even below 98.15, which is the which represents the uptrend line on the daily chart. Going also into the weekly charts for the Kiwi, which is basically we continue to decline all the way last the previous week. We tested the 100-week moving average as mentioned, and then we had a very good bounce right after the Federal Reserve decision, because again the US dollar index is bearish right now, so we should be looking for a dip buy on most of the major currencies against the dollar except the British pound because of the Brexit. So for the time being, I guess there is a very good chance for the Kiwi to start building up all the way back again toward the 70 80s, which is the 50, which represents the 50 day the 50 week moving average. At the same time, technical indicators are almost oversold, and the RSI is starting to tick higher all the way back out toward the 50s. So the Kiwi most likely will start to trend higher, especially that also the support area that held last time, it was also a previous top here, 2015, and now we have the 100-week moving average. I guess it's also another dip buy in the next few days. Looking at the Aussie, made it actually pretty clear, because again New Zealand had some negative data, but in Australia we had a very good data at the same time. So we had this, the biggest actually 1 week increase, a 1 week rally since almost December of this year, which basically opens the way for further gains ahead, especially that this is the first weekly close well above the body or the weekly candles that we've seen for the past few months in September. But at the same time, I would like to see again a break above the 77 20s in order to give us a very clear shot to the upside. But at the same time, as I said, technical indicators are still overbought, which basically keeps the chances higher for a possible retracement to the downside. But a dip buy in the Aussie is also also possible in the next few days. Going into the euro, and after the ECB decision again, so we had a very good upside, and then last week we had, at the beginning of last week, we had some sort of like a very short-term decline, and then after the Federal Reserve decision, we have a very good rally, breaking above the 50, breaking above the 100-day moving average for the first time since almost like 3 weeks, and this is basically a very bullish sign for the time being, despite the fact that looking at the shorter time frame, we have the 108.04 is a very important level to watch, because it represents a very solid resistance area. We tested this level in December 2016, also in January, and right now this is the third time. I believe this time could be the break, especially again that the US dollar index outlook is still negative or still bearish on the downside. So I still believe that we could see some sort of a retracement. I would love to start buying again and building again another position around 106.93 all the way back to 108, and even above that there's a possibility for 108.50s in the next few weeks. Dollar yen, as we said last week, the daily candle, this one was Friday, the previous Friday of last week, which was one of the main reason for a short selling for dollar yen. It continued actually all the way down, and we broke through the 50-day moving average, the 100-day moving average at the same time. This is very important also, and this is basically opens the way for further declines ahead, and probably toward 1160s this week is also very possible. Of course, with some sort of a retracement to the upside, because technical indicators are oversold some sort of, but we can say that we need at least a retracement, probably toward 113.50, where I'll be interested to short the dollar yen again. A British pound also, despite the Brexit, and despite the everyone is waiting for the Article 50 to be triggered. However, we've seen a very good upside last week, all the way to 50 and 100-day moving average. However, we haven't closed last week above those levels, which is a very important level to watch. But don't forget again, despite the fact that the dollar has went down. I still believe the British pound might be one of the worst performer in the next few days and the next few weeks. It doesn't mean that the dollar is going down that the British pound is going to go up, because it doesn't represent that much percentage or weight in the dollar index. I believe the level that we should be watching 124.25, 124.40, 125.50s, where I'll be interested for another short all the way back to 121, especially ahead of the trigger of the Article 50. Going to gold and silver, as we noticed and as we said last week, we were at the beginning of the buying zone, which is the 50 and the 61% Fibonacci on the daily chart from the recent rally since the beginning of December or mid-December of last year. And now, the good thing is, despite the fact that we haven't tested the 50 or 61%, however, we broke above the 50, we broke above the 100 and the 50-day moving average. This is very positive, this is very important bullish engulfing candle on the daily chart. This has turned all of the technical indicators higher, which is still supporting the idea for more upside ahead this year, and at least in the next few days. I would be looking for another test of a 120 or a 1241, and if so, we might also keep on rallying all the way to the 1260s, which is the 200-day moving average again, with the possibility of a break, but this might take another 2 weeks. However, the first level to watch is 1240 for the next few days. Silver was, as I said last week, it was within the buying zone already. That was Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. It was already in the buying zone, so that was very important levels to watch. And right now we have a trend line here, and we broke above the 100-day moving average, tried to break the 50, but it failed to do so. However, the daily candle on Friday was still positive, which basically opens the way for further rally or for further gains ahead, probably towards 1750s. I'll be looking for another rally all the way to that level, especially, again, make it simple. Technical indicators are turning higher, especially after we reach the very or heavily oversold level. Finally, I would like to talk about the DAX, which I believe that it might be the time or the time has come to start looking for a short, especially that we are trying to hold above the 12,000, but at the same time, this is a very important level, the 12,100. At 12,100, but it failed to break above that level and continued all the way down last week. We might see another attempt like to break higher, but however, within the next few weeks, I still believe that we might see some sort of a retracement to the downside, at least to the 50-day moving average, which is 12,050. Also, there's a possibility for the 100,000, which is a 12,000 or 100. Day moving average, which is the 12,000, and as I said, I don't recommend the U.S. equities right now, especially with all the valuations it's over rocketing, and the New York Stock Exchange margin debt has reached a record high, which is I prefer to stay away from the U.S. equities and head toward the European equity, including DAX and also FTSE 100. But today, this week, I'll be focusing on a German DAX or Zeto DAX all the way for another leg lower, probably toward a 12,000 point.
So this is it for the day, and this is it for this video. Thank you for watching, and if you have, again, as always, if you have any questions, any comments, or any feedback, leave them below in the comments, and I'll try to get over them and reply to you as soon as possible. And I'll see you once again next week. Have a good one.